Morning.
This is Tom from Tiny Landscaping. It's a nice, it's the week before Christmas. Nice crisp morning, it's 21 degrees right now. We're just getting ready to start a chamber system. And I wanted to just take a couple minutes before we get all set up to show you how we determine if a dry well will work on a particular property. What we do is I have an auger with a 6-inch bit, and we auger down at least two holes. I'll try to go at least 30 inches down. Our chambers go to 24, and we will auger at least two or three holes. What that does is, first up, that's going to tell me where the water table is, and then we're going to fill one of them up with water. We call that a simple perk test. I know it's not a true perk test, but it usually tells us right away whether we got good drainage or not. So we actually did this test already, but I'm going to do another hole just to show how we do it. Basically, all the two holes. One I'm not going to do anything with. We put a piece of pipe in like this, just to keep the hole from collapsing back in on itself. The other hole we're going to completely fill with water. We come back in 24 hours and we check it. If both holes are completely empty, then we know that not only is there no problem with the water table is not too high for the system, we also know that we drained 30 inches of water inside of 24 hours. So that tells us right away that we got pretty good drainage. Also, when we're augering down, you get a really good feel with what kind of soil you're working with. This one here is a nice kind of a sandy loam, which is kind of what we like to work with. That last job we did in Sarahville, when we were augering down, we knew we were hitting all kinds of stuff. So we knew there was stuff buried down there. We didn't know exactly what it was, but it turned out to be bricks and stuff. I've also had jobs in East Brunswick where we augered down. We did the two holes. Like I said, we put the water into one hole. We come back the next day. The hole that was dry was still bone dry, so no problem with the water table. But the hole that we filled with water, that water didn't move one inch. So we knew we had very, very poor drainage and it wouldn't work. So it gives us a good indication of whether or not the drywall is going to work on a particular property. So I'll auger the hole and show you how we do it. Oh, it's cold. This is going to start. So there's our hole. I don't know if you can see that on camera, but we got this nice sandy loam. Similar to that bank run, but more of a sandy soil. So I know right away with the drainage is gonna be pretty good. This is a piece of old pipe. We put a cap on it just so a little more safety. We're gonna leave it like that. Got two holes here. That's just three now. But one of these we will fill with water. And we'll come back and check it in 24 hours.
Well, this one's been here for 48.
Right, exactly.
Do you want to show them that there's
You can see same nice soil. Really nice, really sandy stuff. This pipe, no water on it at all. About 27 inches down, there's no water whatsoever. So I know I don't have a problem with the water table. I know I got good soil I'm working with, it's gonna drain well. And that's how we know whether it's gonna work or not. So it gives us a good, I always consult the web soil survey. That kind of is a starting point. You can punch in an address or an area and that'll tell you what the soil looks like and give you an idea of where the water table is, but without testing you don't know for sure. So now we know the system's going to work good here. Okay, thanks for watching.